Hello, and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today, I'll be reading Invocation of Azura, which I found in Ruins of Copperheart Orchard, though it most likely was a random drop. Invocation of Azura. For 300 years, I have been a priestess of Azura, the Daedric Prince of Moonshadow, Mother of the Rose, and Queen of the Night Sky. Every Hagatham, which we celebrate on the 21st of First Seed, we summon her for guidance and to give up beautiful things to Her Majesty. She is a cruel but wise mistress. We do not invoke her on any Hagatham troubled by thunderstorms, for those nights belong to the Mad One, Sheogorath. Even if they do coincide with Hagatham, Azura understands our caution. We may summon her on other dates also, and she quite often responds. The only days we are forbidden to invoke her are those prescribed to one of the other 15 princes, the 1st and the 13th of Morning Star, the 2nd and the 16th of Sun's Dawn, the 5th of First Seed, the 9th of Rain's Hand, the 9th of Second Seed, the 5th of Mid-Year, the 10th of Sun's Height, the 3rd of Hearthfire, the 8th and the 13th of Frostfall, the 2nd and 20th of Sun's Dusk, and the 20th of Evening Star. I know who is summoned on the 3rd of Hearthfire, the 2nd of Sun's Dusk, and the 20th of Evening Star, but I am not certain of the others. It is enough that Azura has forbidden those dates. Azura's invocation is a very personal one. I have been the priestess of 3 other Daedric princes, but Azura values the quality of her worshippers, the truth behind our adoration of her, and the... When I was a dark elven maiden of 16, I joined my grandmother's coven, worshippers of Malag Bal, the schemer prince. Blackmail, extortion, and bribery are as much the weapons of the witches of Molag Bal as magic is. The invocation of Molag Bal is held on the 20th of Evening Star, except in stormy weather. This ceremony is seldom missed, but Molag Bal often appears to his cultists in mortal guise on other dates. When my grandmother died in an attempt to poison the heir of Firewatch, I re-examined my faith in the cult. My brother was a warlock of the cult of Boethia, and from what he told me, the dark warrior is closer to my spirit than the treacherous Molag Bal. Boethia is a warrior prince who acts more overtly than any other Daedra. After years of skulking and scheming, it felt good to perform acts for my mistress which had immediate consequences. Besides, I like that Boethia is a Daedra of the Dark Elves. Our cult would summon her on the day we called the Gauntlet, the 2nd of Sun's Dusk. Bloody competitions would be held in her honor, and the duels and battles would continue until 9 cultists were killed at the hands of the other cultists. Boethia cared little for her cultists. She only cared about her blood. I do think I saw her smile when I accidentally slew my brother in a spar. My horror, I think, greatly pleased her. I left the cult soon after that. Boethia was too impersonal for me, too cold. I wanted a master of greater depth than she. For the next 18 years of my life, I worshipped no one. I read and researched. It was in an old and profane tome I came upon the name of Nocturnal. Nocturnal the Night Mistress, Nocturnal the Unfathomable. As the book prescribed, I called to her on her holy day, the 3rd of Hearthfire. At last, I had found the personal mistress I had so long desired. I strove to understand her labyrinthine philosophy, the source of her mysterious pain. Everything about her was dark and shrouded, even the way she spoke and the acts she required of me. It took years for me to understand the simple fact that I could never understand Nocturnal. Her mystery was as essential to her as savagery was to Boethia or treachery was to Molag Bal. To understand Nocturnal is to negate her, to pull back the curtains in her realm of darkness. As much as I loved her, I recognized the futility of unraveling her enigmas. I turn instead to her sister, Azura. Azura is the only Daedra prince I have ever worshipped who seems to care about her cultists. Molag Bal wanted my mind, Boethia wanted my arms, and Nocturnal, perhaps my curiosity. Azura wants all of that, and our love. Not our abject slavering, but our honest and genuine love in all its forms. It's important to her that our emotions are engaged, and our love must also be directed inward. If we love her and hate ourselves, she feels our pain. I will have no other mistress. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall, Invocation of Azura.